Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Hemambika from Department of S&H, Humanities and Sciences from the St. Martin's Engineering College. Now, I would like to discuss about the topic of chemistry. This is volumetric analysis. So, it plays a very vital role nowadays that all the students can do their experiments by using this volumetric analysis, right? What called analysis? If a substance can be taken place, so that substance, how it can be analyzed, how it can be titrated against, those objects can be discussed in this way, right? So here the topic name is volumetric analysis. Generally in the analysis topic, there are two kinds of things. First one, it is classical methods and instrumental methods. In the classical methods, all the volumetric things like volume, consumption through which the concentration can be calculated. So these are of four kinds that I want to discuss today. So here the first one is complexometric titrations, acid-base titrations, redox titrations, and precipitation titrations. Yes, here the complexometric titrations are nothing but to form a complex between the metal and the ligand. When a metal is supposed to react with a ligand, so then automatically their formation of a complex. So which is in the presence of an indicator. Why we are using an indicator? Indicator is to use to identify the end point, which is through a color change. Either, for example, it is like colorless to pink, like blue to pale pink, like this, any kind of color change can be obtained through a metal can be reacted against a ligand. Right, for example, take a metal of zinc. Zinc is having capability of losing two electrons and to form 2+ ions and 2 electrons. But here, when it's supposed to react with a ligand, for example, zinc is reacted with a ligand like EDTA, which is directly form a complex with EDTA, like zinc EDTA. But whereas in titration methods, here for example we are taking the titer in the burette, right? So what kind of solutions we are taking in the burette whose concentration is known, okay, whose concentration is already calculated. So those kind of solutions are taken in the burette. And whereas in the conical flask, whose concentration is to be calculated. So by this way, zinc sulfate solution, we are taking zinc sulfate solution. Here we are taking in the conical flask. Through which we are adding some kind of buffer solution to which, why we are using buffer solution. So this buffer solution is to maintain the complex stability. Why? This zinc reacts with an EDTA, therefore its complex should be stable up to certain time. By using this buffer solution, this can be applicable. Right. Here one kind of indicator is also to be used in the volumetric analysis, means classical methods of analysis. We are preferring a kind of indicator. Why it is using? Why? Because if any kind of color change can be observed by using an indicator. So what is the work of an indicator? For example, zinc reacts with an EBT, therefore which forms a zinc EBT as a complex. Generally, in the laboratory point of view, EBT is in blue in color. But whereas when it reacts with a zinc sulfate solution, then automatically which is converted into a, or which appears as wine red in color. Right. So this wine red in color of zinc EBT is make a complex in the conical flask as it is. Therefore, this is titrated against the burette. The solution which is containing in this is EDTA. So this EDTA solution acts as a ligand. Okay. So this is again titrated against through which. Therefore, then automatically this complex is a weak complex. Zinc EBT complex is a weak complex. So this can be replaced with a strong ligand. So here EDTA is a strong ligand. The main characteristic of the EDTA is a strong. Therefore, this zinc EBT can be replaced with EDTA titrated against ruburate, therefore, which gives zinc EDTA as a complex, and EBD is free in state. Right. So this EDTA zinc complex is a colorless complex, and whereas EBD itself is a bluing color, therefore the endpoint color changes blue color, which means the colorless complex is the color is dominated by a colored EBT ligand. Therefore, the endpoint color changes wild red to blue. Okay, so this is about the complexometric titrations. Whereas we are coming to discuss about the acid base titrations. Acid againest react with the base. So which is nothing but called as neutralization reactions. Well, an acid reacts with a base, therefore which gives salt as well as water formation. This is also one kind of visual titration like complexometric titrations. Therefore, it needs one kind of indicator which gives a color change at its endpoint. So here, strong acid strong base combination, or weak acid strong base combination, or strong acid weak base combination can be applicable within the presence of an indicator. Therefore, which forms a salt as well as water combination. So here, for example, we are taking HCl as a strong acid and NaOH is a strong base, which is titrated against through this. Therefore, which is a phenolphthalein indicator can be applicable. For suppose we are taking HCl as an acid, this is taken in the conical flask, and NaOH is a base, which is taken in the burette. So this acid titrated against the burette, therefore which gives a color change endpoint through the indicator like phenolphthalein as an indicator. So, this is one kind of example of acid-base titrations. Okay, next, the third one is redox titrations. Redox means both reduction as well as oxidation takes place simultaneously in a same kind of reaction. This is named as redox titrations or redox reactions. This is also visual titration, therefore which requires one kind of indicator which exhibits a color change at its endpoint. Which is, here we are using DPA as an indicator. Here diphenylamine is an indicator. For example, we are taking iron 2 plus means ferrous ammonium sulfate as titrated against chromium 6 means potassium dichromate. Right, this is ferrous ammonium sulfate, this is potassium dichromate. For example, iron 2 plus is converted into iron 3 plus when it reacts against chromium 6, and this chromium 6 on reacted with an iron 2 which is converted into chromium 6. Therefore, this is one oxidation state is increased, so it is named as oxidation which undergo oxidation, and whereas its oxidation state is reduced, therefore it is known as reduction. So, guys, here the oxidation as well as reduction are taking place simultaneously in a same reaction. Therefore, the corresponding reactants can be converted into the products. Okay, so here let us take this iron 2 as ferrous ammonium sulfate in the conical flask, and chromium 6 is taken in the burette, means potassium dichromate is taken in the burette. Right, these two are titrated against by using a DP as an indicator. Then the oxidation states will be changed according to this. So this is undergo oxidation and this is supporting for the reduction, therefore it is otherwise named as reductant or reducing agent. At the same time, this undergo reduction and therefore this is help for the oxidation, so it is named as oxidant. From which we come to understand that a redox titration can be carried by using a reductant titrated against an oxidant, or oxidant titrated against a reductant, or we can make in a higher education that both two reductants can be applied with a titration with one oxidant. Like two oxidants can be reacted participation with one oxidant. Like that, there may be so many types of combinations. This is a visual titration, therefore DPA is an indicator here, and within the presence of sulfuric acid for its supporting agent. So in the presence of strong acid, this reaction is carried through. Next, precipitation titration. Precipitation titration itself, it is nothing but at its end point, there is a formation of a precipitate, right? So this precipitation titration may follow through this complexometric, followed by an acid base, followed by a redox. So all these combination gives precipitation. Not only a single precipitation can be carried in a single reaction. For example, we are taking silver nitrate titrated against some kind of chloride. Okay, take NaCl, take HCl, any kind of chlorides, fluorides, like that. Okay, so these kind of reactions are named as argentometric titrations, whereas this silver, it is called argentinium. As its Latin name is argentinium, therefore its titration name is argentometric titrations, right? So here silver nitrate titrated against chloride. So in this chloride containing element is taken in a conical flask, and silver nitrate is taken in a burette, which is titrated against. For the color change, we are applying K2CrO4, that is called potassium chromate, as an indicator. So in this indicator, this chloride ions reacts with the silver, therefore which forms as silver chloride, which is a precipitate. White color turbid precipitate will occur. So by using this, silver chloride will be formed. So this is one kind of precipitation titration, and this is a redox titration, and this is a acid base titration, and this is a complexometric titration. So nowadays all the practical analysis can be carried. One of the part is this one. Okay. Next, coming to in this instrumental analysis. In the instrumental analysis, different kinds of instruments can be used, like potentiometers, conductometers, pH meters, spectrophotometers. Okay, like that, different kinds of instruments can be carried out. So here potentiometric titrations to calculate potential. Here conductometric practical is to determine conductance, and pH to determine pH values, and spectrophotometric practical can be detected the concentration against absorbance. So these are the things we can come to understand that. So the same things, for example, take potentiometric titration. So in this potentiometric titration, here this redox titrations, we have taken the example of iron and chromium. The same practical can be carried with using this potentiometric titration. Here, instruments can take part of different kinds of readings. Okay, so to calculate the potential value, what is the potential difference is occurred in the reaction processing. Therefore, it is one kind of instrumental technique. So here, no need of any kind of indicator is should be used for volumetric analysis or for visual titrations only. This is applicable. Okay, guys. So let us take the potentiometric titration. It is simply this iron 2 titrated against chromium. This gives this kind of information. So the same oxidation as well as the reduction will be taken part by using potentiometric titration. Here also take a beaker. In that you should add some kind of iron solution. And here the thing is to understand electrodes. Okay, these are the different kinds of, there are different kinds of electrodes. For example, reference electrodes, indicator electrodes are there. So the reference electrode whose potential is to be known, and whose potential is known, that is named as reference electrode, and whose potential is to be calculated, that is named as indicator electrode. Okay. So here, these are the two electrodes we are applying to calculate the potential difference. So we are applying here platinum white as well as saturated calomel electrode. So this is a saturated calomel electrode, and this is a platinum wire. This saturated calomel electrode is named as reference electrode and platinum wire is named as indicator electrode. So saturated calomel electrode whose potential is known and platinum electrode whose potential is to be calculated. So which two are dipped into a solution containing a beaker through which the potential difference can be carried through. So here we are applying, for example, iron 2 as a solution, and for example, if you are titrating against, here also burette you are using, we are titrating against chromium 6. So when this iron 2 is titrated against chromium 6, then automatically there is a fluctuation in the reading of potential can be observed through this. So where there is a large potential difference is observed when iron 2 is reacted against chromium, then automatically there is a graphical representation is to be carried out. So where the potential difference, rapid potential difference is to be carried out, that it is named as potential difference occur when chromium is titrated against iron 2. Right. So here also the same reaction has been taken part. Like that, the same kind of volumetric analysis can be carried through by using instrumental methods of analysis. In the conductometric titrations, it is used to calculate the conductance. Conductance, it is nothing but the passes of ions through a solution or passes of ions through a substance. How much passes of ions is carried out, that is its conductance. The reciprocal to which is resistance. So it is based upon the Ohm's law, we can come to understand that how much conductance is calculated when a chemical reaction is carried out. So for example, this is applicable to the acid-base titrations. For example, an acid reacts with a base, how much conductance is being carried out. Here also one kind of conductometer it is like a electrode is applicable, it is known as conductivity electrode. Okay, so this conductivity electrode, to measure conductance. So this is applicable acid-base titration. Here also we can take strong acid, weak acid, strong base, like that. It is also applicable. Okay, so for visual titrations or volumetric analysis, acid-base titrations, the same thing carried with the instrument called conductance. So like that, these are the things we can understand by using volumetric analysis. So here classification means classical methods of analysis and instrumental methods of analysis. This classical methods of analysis is representing with the volumetric analysis itself. So there is a relation between volume and concentration. When volume is consumed, concentration is to be calculated. There is a M1V1 equal to M2V2. So here by N1 by N2. So there is a method of calculation by using this formula. Okay. So either here in the molarities or in terms of normalities, we can able to understand that if suppose it is a normal. So N1V1 equal to N2V2. Either this formula or this formula can be carried. For example, this is used in the conical flask, this is used in the burette. So conical flask, volume is and concentration is to be calculated by using burette reading, volume, consumption. So here burette reading, concentration is known and volume is burette reading volume. And here volume is taken in the conical flask and here normality is to be calculated. Therefore, we can apply N2V2 by N1. By this formula, we can able to identify normality of the unknown solution which is taken in a conical flask. So by this method, we can able to understand. Next one, in the same way, here M1V1 equal to M2V2, this formula is also can be applicable. Okay, so we are able to understand that the concentration of a solution can be calculated in terms of molarities or normalities. Okay,